So for this little demonstration, I wanted to give everyone a good understanding of how to take a character and how to break it down so that it's usable in Flash. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drag around my character and select. And if you zoom in, you can see that the little cross pattern on the lines, well, that means it's selected. So I'm going to move it into the center of my stage. I'm going to use the free transform tool, which gives it these little anchor points. I could rotate it or scale it. And I'm going to scale it up to a size that makes it a little bit easier to draw. And you notice that I can go beyond the stage. It doesn't matter because we're going to be recreating it from this point. So you can see I have my little boy here who's in a funny little monkey suit. And we're going to see if I can make him work. So you'll see that right here, he's on the layer sketch. I'm going to make a new layer. Okay. This layer we're going to call body. Now what I'm doing is I'm creating a set of layers that works very much like you do a paper doll, that you might have the body on one layer and then accessories, different heads or things like that on different layers. So for Flash, we want to break down all of the parts to different layers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lock that layer. You can see by clicking this little lock icon that that layer is locked. I can't grab or change or do anything to it. I'm highlighted on the body layer, and now I can begin to draw. So I'm going to choose a different color. I chose an off-green so that I knew when I was drawing my black that I would go over top of it and I'd see what's new. Now my original drawing is quite rough, and so what I can do from here is perfect it and go over. So I'm just going to start with the body. Now, the body I know goes behind the head, and I want to be able to use this whole piece separately, separate from the arm, separate from the legs, from the head, the ears, and the tail. So as I draw, I'm not being too careful, and I know I have a line there that I filled in. That's okay. I'm going to have a little kind of zipper that goes up here. In the end, I'll close it around so I can fill it. Now, I'm not adding anything for the arms or detail. That's one piece of the body. Next, I'm going to add a new layer, and I'm going to do the next part, and I'm going to go and do the backpack. Now, I'm going to bring this below the backpack and the tail, and I can do those basically on the same layer, but I'm going to do the backpack next. I'll just call it backpack, all one word there. Great. So now on that layer, I know this backpack has to go behind. And again, because I'm going to have to fill it with colors, I need to make sure it's a solid enclosure, very much like I did with the body. So I'm going to lock the body so I don't interfere with it. And here we go. Get the kind of little edge of the backpack. Little kind of flap down. And a little piece that kind of goes on the side. And a bit there. Great. Now if I hide everything else, I'll be able to see that needs to get enclosed. So this needs to go behind so I can fill it there, and this piece will need to go in behind the body and there, and I can fill those two pieces now, and that part will just stay black. Okay, so backpack done, body outline ready to go. So next, behind the body but above the backpack, we're going to do another new layer, and this time I'm going to do the legs. So I'll rename the layer to legs. So here I go. Now the legs will change depending on my scene. But in this case, just for now, I'm going to draw them all as one little piece. And you notice that I'm not exactly the same as my original sketch, and that's okay because I can erase and fix things later if I need to. See that I have a little opening right here, and I want to make sure I get that gap nice and closed. Perfect. Now again, if I hide my body, you'll see that I can hide my backpack too. You'll see that my legs are not closed. And I want them to go up into the body just like that. So they're sealed and I can fill those their own color. So if I choose to make my my little outfit, let's see what would be a good monkey color. Let's give them a nice reddish brown like this. And with my bucket, you'll see that I can now come in and I can fill that. If I go to my body layer, let's see, I should be able to fill that one unless there's a little hole I'm not seeing. I can zoom in and check. And it looks pretty good. Well, maybe I'm wrong. Let's find out. Let's choose close medium gap, see if that fills. Oh, it helps if you don't have the layer locked, which I did. So I don't want to make selected because I don't want to change my black color, and I just want to fill this one. There we go. So here's everything as we see it now. See that that's coming together. Now, after I'm all done, I'll come back for the highlights. So I'm just going to take that out so I can see beyond the body. I'm going to lock all of the layers I've done so far. And let's move on to the arms. So I'll make a new layer. Now I know one arm, okay, his left arm is going to go above the body. And his right arm is going to go below it. So let's start with right arm. Okay. And here we go. I'm going to make it a little t-shirt. Oops, forgot to change my color back to black. Little t-shirt here, and I'll go in. Now, I noticed that I just zoomed in, and I don't like the kind of the thickness I have on my line weight. So I'm going to zoom out again so I can make sure I can get it right this time. And there we go. Try one more time. I wasn't quite happy with how that went. There we go. So we're going to come in here, make a little piece. And now if I want to make that arm go up and down, I'll have that whole piece. For the next part, I'm just going to do a little quick. I didn't do it very good the first time, so I'm going to make it a little bit better the next time. And I can use my eraser tool and just touch up that edge just a bit. So I'm a little happier with that. There we go. And that looks like a nice little arm there. Great. Okay, let's do the next one. So, now the right arm is right now above the body. Bring it down below, left arm above. Lock all the layers. Let's do the next arm. Oops. Still on eraser. Let's make sure I'm on my brush tool. Go to the left arm layer so I can work. There we go. Get his arm and turn around there. Perfect. Might be a little small. I can change that later if I decide. Okay, so now that we've got some arms in, let's not forget the tail. I'm going to put that layer below the body. So let's add tail. And I can draw that one in. And I know it kind of comes from the center of his backside here. And I'm just going to do a little close again. I can fill that with whatever color I like. All right, now I guess we're on to the head. I'm going to do the head as separate parts. I'm going to do the head as the whole head, ears, hair, nose, but mouth and eyes I'll do on separate layers. So I can change those out and I can swap them out as I need. So when he's happy or he blinks or whatever, I don't have to redraw the whole head. So I'll call it head base.